A North Sea bear is the workman who actually does the work. Some think the term is belittling, and others think it is a real badge of courage to put on them. After all, working in the North Sea is somewhat of a hazardous job. And some of them wear it with pride.
Walter Anderson and his team produced the master plan for hookup.
You have to get the right man at the right place with the right material. You have to feed him, you have to clothe him, you have to transport him, you have to take care of him, make sure he's safe, you have to train him.
You also have to entertain him. Few cinemas can boast a full house every night, but then where else could you find such a captive audience? For the bears, this is no picnic. It's a good job they're not just here for the beer, because there isn't any. They're here for the money and to work flat out for 14 days each trip. 12 hours on, 12 off. Night or day, it's all the same. And for that kind of effort, any bear needs building up. So every month they munch their way through 27,000 pounds of beef, 22,000 pounds of fresh fruit, 50,000 pounds of vegetables, and a lot more besides. All washed down with the help of 370,000 tea bags, which in 4 weeks is a lot of cuppers. Mealtimes are the high spots of every day, and no one's below the salt in this offshore hotel. There's no second class here.
Everyone had the same rank. There was no such thing as reserve tables, different meals or anything. We were all one team. You could find a supervisor in the worst cabins or the best, and a bear could be in the similar cabin. We did not, however, mix the bears and the supervisors in the same cabin. As it said, the bears might have complained.
Sid, what we're proposing to do is to put both of the cask compressors on.
We need to run C up so that we can trip A up.
2926, 2933.
The deadline for first oil moves closer. The startup team checks out the complex process system, the electrics, the 1,001 interconnections between the modules.
Okay, Derek, go ahead and go and give that valve a thump.
The complete structure has to handle 100,000 barrels of oil a day, plus 12,000 barrels of natural gas liquids, and 200,000 barrels of water injection. It includes a sophisticated gas sweetening unit, 2 drilling modules, enough power generation to light up a small town, and living quarters for 240 men. Then, of course, there's the vital mini airport, that helipad.
Okay, lads, I reckon we could give it a go and see what happens.
All right. Okay, Derek, give it a start.
Okay, man, keep your fingers crossed.
Let's really try and finalise all our process instrumentation checks and all our shutdown checks and get them out of the way. And then if time permits, and I think we should go back and do a sustained performance run.
Yeah.
By July, they're ready for oil. The biggest clean-up and de-rigging gets underway as the bears clock on for the last night shift. There's talk of bringing first oil forward. 3 days earlier than planned, the marathon team begins the final countdown to first oil. The bears are mobilized for the airlift home.
We'll meet again, don't know where, don't know where.
Roger, we'll be backtracking to the 060 radio traffic at 2,500 feet. 1 hour and 7 minutes on route time.
56 Hotel, ETA 1655, routed to the DB.
Everyone sells on board, 2,200 pounds, 1 plus 5, 5, and affirmative freight.
Oh, will you please say hello to the folks that I know? Tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know.
We lost the facility of 728 beds when the DB100 pulled finally this morning.
We've completed our whole running of all our process system, our separation train, our booster pumps, our export pumps, We completed our DOE system check. We demonstrated a full emergency shutdown system check throughout the whole platform, which included all our running equipment and all our process train.
How about that export pump bypass line? Is that open now?
CCR, come back.
Hey, Ed.
Yes,
it's Bob.
Hey, Bob.
We started opening the choke valve for first oil at 0241.
We're starting to drop now in the LP. So you can start pumping now.
Just give me a call as soon as you're ready, because what we need to do is to get some flow forward, because there's a lot of gas going to the flare. There's no point in lighting it until we've got some more gas coming behind it.
Yeah, OK, we'll get back to you.
July the 12th, 1983, Brae Alpha comes on stream. The 22nd field in the North Sea starts pumping out the oil.
Dave, what's our rate now?
15,200 barrels per day.
Perhaps we'll go about another 30, 45 minutes and increase it to 20,000 barrel per day.
Oh, will you please say hello to the folks that I know?
As the last bear leaves Brae Alpha, they're already planning, wouldn't you know, for the arrival of the first bear on North Brae.